like I push against the cloud. They just keep blocking out the sun. It seems since I was born, I've wakened every blessed morning down on my luck and up against the wind. Don't you stop, don't you run.
Psalms tells us, "For you, O God, have tested us. You have tried us. We went through fire and through water. Yet you have brought us out to a place of abundance. We went through fire and through water. Yet you have brought us out to a place of abundance."
Safety inside the petrochemical industry is a very important issue. Is it something that belongs on the president's lap? I believe as long as he appoints the appropriate people to head his departments, the president himself probably doesn't need to weigh in a whole lot.
In 2011, 1,400 non-fatal injuries and illnesses occurred in Texas alone. Thousands of families have been affected by individuals working in hazardous workplaces.
At ExxonMobil, we have standards and procedures whereby we take special measures to see to it that none of these things happen. But occasionally, things do happen. The incoming president needs to be made acutely aware that this is a dangerous industry. Essentially, we have rules in place that we follow, procedures and safe operating procedures that guide us in terms of the different type of work we do. An operator has to make rounds and check equipment. You have to understand that equipment and know how it works and how to address situations with it if there's some problems. But you also have to be aware of your surroundings. And the key thing about being aware of your surroundings is to have the proper equipment. It's because everybody wants to go home at night to their loved ones, but also to the people you work with and also to the surrounding community.
Safety should be a number one priority if you're working inside the plant. As we were discussing, each of the plants deal with dangerous chemicals. There's dangerous jobs involving the chemicals. So safety should be a number one priority.
In May of 2016, a contractor working at the facility you see behind me died when a pipe fell and hit him in his neck and head. The facility spokesman refused to answer any questions. Chris Lampson, CEO of the International Safety Council, says safety is everyone's responsibility.
Safety is your responsibility. It's an individual responsibility. The companies can provide training, companies can provide personal protective equipment, but ultimately the employee working on the job site is responsible for his or her own safety.
The biggest, the most important thing they express is working safely. If you can't work safely in a refinery, you can't work there. You have to not only be responsible for yourself and doing the right things to keep yourself safe, but also other people you work with.
Better safety equipment and improved safety measures should be put in place by the federal government. Contractors are hired each year, and in majority of the cases, they are the individuals getting hurt.
What we do here at ISTC is we provide safety training for the contractors that work inside the petrochemical industry here in Southeast Texas. And we do that through agreements with the plants. They tell us what their requirements are for a contractor to get inside the plant, and then we ensure those requirements are met. Some plants may require confined space. The plants have all these towers and tanks, and workers get pretty high up. Usually accidents are can be a result of complacency. An individual's tired, they aren't thinking again, and it's still up to the individual to use the equipment correctly and to remember to be safe.
I've been in areas where I've seen things happen. We had a piece of equipment called a heat exchanger that did not have a plug in the very top of it, and the unit across the way from where I work was putting that piece of equipment back into service. And when they did, the hot tar that they run through that exchanger was exposed to the atmosphere. And some of this stuff is so hot that it will auto-ignite. And all of a sudden, it was like something touched me on my shoulder and tapped me like, look this way. And I turned to look, and I saw flames shooting up about 50 to 60 feet in the air.
Mr. President, I believe the government needs to make all workplaces safer by increasing training, security, and providing better equipment. The number of accidents will decrease, and more mothers and fathers can return home safely. In Beaumont, I'm Bryan Brown, reporting for C-SPAN.
Don't you stop, don't you run, don't you run.